Dr. D.J. Dhar, respected Mahatma Ji, Acharya Ji, Sadhvi Ji, respected Shri Prem Chand Ji Dhar, or indicator Sadhvika Ji, Director Betty, or a distinguished guest, Mr. Verma is there, His Excellency Verma is there, Dr. Lin Arya, Mr. S.B. Jain, Dr. Chauhan, Engineer O.P. Agarwal, Mr. Shankun Singh, Labor Secretary Wong, Government member of the faculty, I met some of them and I was very much impressed with them. Invitees, guests, students, members of the alumni of the Institute, friends from press and media, ladies and gentlemen. It is not only a great pleasure, but also an honor for me to be present here today on the occasion of the convocation of the students of the 15th batch of the Institute, passing of the postgraduate diploma in business studies. Dear students, management today is a complicated and scientific term. The world is moving very fast. The economies of the various countries, business system, practices, and structuring are also undergoing very rapid change, all due to fast growing trend of industrialization and globalization. Industries and business are not now nation-specific, but have become multinationals, all due to economy and scale of operation. Management expertise, optimal utilization of the financial resources, and also unlimited marketing opportunities. This has led to acquisition of business and globalization of companies. To cope up with the challenges taking place in the world economy, industry and business, it is very important that our education system is such which impart training to the students to meet the eventualities arising out of different circumstances in different countries and different places. It is very satisfying to know that Ishan Institute of Management and Technology was set up with the primary objective of developing a center for excellence in management at affordable cost in best infrastructure. Friends, I am greatly impressed with the founder of the Institute, Dr. D.K. Dhar. In fact, I met him 2 days ago at this place in another function, and I came to know about the kind of knowledge. He is completely a knowledge bank. He himself is an institute, a completely dedicated person towards the teaching and taken as teaching as a profession. A social worker towards the benefit of the poor people by giving them spiritual input since childhood. He organized Havana to eliminate untouchables in Hazel Basti and Burkhardt. I am really great admirer of him, and that is the reason I am present today in this ceremony. It is further satisfying to know that this institute is laying emphasis of nurturing talent which would enrich national fabric and act as a driving force in transforming the country to lofty and talented future. I am confident that syllabus and curriculum of this institute impart such education and training in developing capabilities needed for managing business effectively and efficiently, so that the students are able to handle competitive situations and take the future responsibility at the global level. Friends, the need today is to produce business managers of international standard with integrated capabilities, interactive skills and innovation through development of fundamental managerial ability, analytic skills, practical orientation, and ability to perform under pressure to create multifaceted facility. It is heartening to learn that this institute is providing all these aspects of education, training and learning. I am confident that all those who are passing out today the postgraduate diploma in management studies will prove out to be excellent managers in the respective field in which they undertake the job. I have come to know that this institute, besides teaching syllabus and curriculum, extracurricular activities like seminar and presentation, also has special time for daily prayer and periodical yagyas. This is an excellent way to provide Western education in Eastern atmosphere. In other words, attempt is being made to integrate the best of the East and the West. Prayer and yagya make a person disciplined in following a defined path. Daily prayers are an offering to the God Almighty for achieving the best in a day. Similarly, yagya is a mass ceremony performed by Acharya or Pandit by enchanting mantras, followed by enchanting a mantra by the participants in the yagya. Even though the participants sometimes may not understand the meaning of the mantra, yet they follow the Pandit or Acharya as a ritual and enchant the same. This is a good example of following the leadership. Today, I am really touched. Once this institute has brought out a complete set of the audio and video CD on Vedas, which is really a novel and a very interesting as well as a practical idea to keep up the same pace of learning in this institute as well as something new and available in practice for all of us. While the syllabus and curriculum of the management education teaches the basic principles of handling various aspects of operation of management business, there are many things which are learned by individuals out of their common sense, knowledge, alertness to surroundings, and day-to-day happening, which also enable them to cope up with the different issues and problems. While educational training is very important, it is also important to learn and understand changing social values. This morning, when I had an opportunity to attend this morning yagya and the Mahatmaji, Pravachan basically was on the moral value of the society. I am really touched on that subject. It is also important to learn and understand these changing social values and moral values for the social fabric, living realities, and utilize common knowledge and common intelligence and common sense in solving various issues and problems. If we are not aligned to the social aspects, economic realities, and trends and systems of the society, we cannot become a good manager purely on the basis of education we receive in the colleges. I would therefore urge all the students passing out today to be very live and to be alert to the society, to the circumstances and to the surroundings in which they will be operating, keeping in with the social system, trends and applications. Many managers who have tried to apply theoretical knowledge in a copycat style in solving the problems of day-to-day business have failed miserably because they did not take into account the hard realities of the circumstances in which the problem arose and the reasons for the problem. Application of the common sense is very, very important as far as the daily working is concerned. Let us look at the army who are called off and on for solving various types of problems of society. Why is it so? It is not because they are trained to use their common sense and common knowledge besides their political knowledge in solving problems. I remember an interesting incident of a group discussion in the one of the IMA leadership program. In which the selection was being made for some of the officers for the IMA. In that particular example, I would like to say that there was a truck with a height of 6 feet 3 inch, which was to pass through a bridge whose height was only 6 feet. Various persons connected with them for taking the truck to the bridge made various suggestions. Someone suggested that the gate of the bridge should be removed so that there is no restriction of height. Somebody suggested that the height of the truck should be reduced By removing the side portion of the truck, but a man with a common sense suggested that the tire may be deflated so that to the 3 inches, so that the height of the truck reduces by 3 inches, and the truck could pass through the bridge. This is a good example of application of a very common sense, and that is derived from the today's managers. These days, young generation passing out of the management schools have a passion of for building their career and keep on changing their job after about a year or two years in an office to improve their better. I would like to warn here that they forget that going strong does not wear the mask. While they may not be successful in opening job after job with higher pay packages, they forget that they are able to achieve only monetary benefits, but what they have lost is the actual experience of doing a job or a project in a given period of time in a proven way. Such persons indicate the tendency of not being loyal and sincere to the organization. They work hard and show selfish tendency. It is important that the person should at least work for a period of 4 to 5 years to prove their worth of making some effective contribution to the organization, which can be highlighted in their biodata, and which may perhaps give them a higher jump in the financial package than they otherwise get related. I am not suggesting that one should not be ambitious and passionate about the growth in their career. What I am suggesting is only that one should give enough time to prove one's worth in an organization and make suitable contribution in the growth of the organization before switching to the another organization. This gives a lot of experience besides mental and professional satisfaction. In the end, I would like to emphasize that the development of the interpersonal skills in an individual is a very important aspect to be successful in handling a business. It is also important to develop capabilities for motivating team members to achieve the defined objective efficiently and effectively. While these qualities do not come out of education, but these can be created by practice and improving communication and behavioral patterns with colleges and other team members. It is also important to do an ordinary and routine work with extra enthusiasm, zeal and spirit, so that the ordinary and routine work become extraordinary. I am not a management expert, but I have definitely learned a lot in my professional career through experience of day-to-day interaction with my colleagues, senior leaders and others. And I believe, and I firmly believe that process of learning continues till the end and does not stop after finishing a course. I am sure that the students passing out today also believe in these principles and will practice the same in future. My best wishes to all of you for excellent professional life in future. Thank you very much.